How's it going, everyone? Shane here with ScoopHash, and I'm back with another weekly episode of my series all about the opinions I have that other people don't like. I've covered a wide variety of topics on this show. I've covered the Lord of the Rings books and movies, the MCU, I've covered video games, and this week I'm going back to movies. Specifically talk about a movie that came out 3-4 years ago that just everyone in the film world lost their shit over, just loved and adored, and they continue to, and I continue to not understand it. And this movie is La La Land. Now the good thing about La La Land, I may not like it, but it has given us something absolutely incredible and possibly the greatest moment in all of the Academy Awards history, where it was announced to have won Best Picture when actually Moonlight had won. Maybe it's just the pettiness and my own sort of vindication for not really liking the movie, but that part, that felt good. That felt good. Now, La La Land, La La Land, directed by Damien Chazelle? Is that how you pronounce it? Damien? We're going to call him Damien. Damien, hold on, let me look this up. La La Land. Damien Chazelle! La La Land, directed by Damien Chazelle, was a sort of meant to be a renaissance of the Hollywood story and musicals, and it starts out quite excellent. I really do love the opening scene of the movie, this sort of one-shot dance number on the highway. It not only is a perfect example of traffic in LA and that kind of poking fun at that, but it also is just beautifully shot, and it gets the movie off on a really incredible foot that it hooked me, and maybe that's why the things that happened later that I didn't like caused such a negative reaction. It was because it started out so good and hooked me. But you know, we meet our two main characters, Emma Stone and Ryan Gosling. They're both good, they're both excellent, they're both fantastic and talented artists, and they both bring a lot of depth and humor and charisma to their characters while also having a lot of solid chemistry in their relationship. And you know, it progresses, it's really entertaining, it's really good. There are some really good musical numbers, the soundtrack is great, and Chazelle definitely has an eye for filming and bringing beauty out into each and every frame. But then it just kind of derails itself for me, and the moment it derails itself is when John Legend comes into the movie. And it's not because I dislike John Legend, it's because it was at that moment when his character entered the story that I knew exactly how the movie was going to end, where Ryan Gosling's character would more or less sell out to try to achieve his dreams, Emma Stone would get some sort of acting offer that would be away from him, and those two things would ultimately add conflict, they'd break up, and we would end with a, oh, we were in love, but life forced us to split. And it was at that moment that I realized that I was watching Oscar bait. The movie just, in almost every way, seemed to be aiming for that award. It wasn't, by the end of the movie, I didn't feel like I was watching a movie that was trying to tell its own story. I was watching a movie that was made in order to win an award. And that was really frustrating to me because it starts out so good and I hated how predictable it got by the end. And I'm just so burnt out and I'm over this idea and this cliche that's been in movies for a few years now, where it was in response to older movies kind of being picture perfect. And at the end, you know, the two lead, they get together, the guy gets the girl and vice versa, and they're in love and they're happy. And so we started having movies where it was like, well, that doesn't always happen, which was good. That was needed, and I'm not saying that that kind of story isn't believable, because that is what happens. But at the same time, it's almost gotten to the point where every modern movie now has to have that it's become the new cliche. And this idea of, well, you can't live your life and achieve your dreams while also being in love, just really bothers me, because that's not real. There's no truth to that, really. I mean, sure, if you want to focus on your career and your dreams, that's fine, but I don't know. I feel like there are ways you can make both work. I mean, life is all about compromise. Relationships are all about compromise. You give and you take, and you try to find a way for both parties to be happy. And I want a movie where I see that, where I see two people making the effort and the sacrifices to not to be happy within what they're doing in their life, while also being happy in their relationship. And I just feel like that's such a new mindset that we have now of there's love and a family, and then there's your career. And if you want to be successful in your career, you got to give up the family and vice versa. And I just feel like there's a gray area that needs to be explored. And so that really did upset me in the movie. It was just how when John Legend comes in, I knew it was happening. And at that point, I don't know. It just really bugged me, and then it really bugged me that at the end they kind of pull a double bait and switch where, like, she comes to his club, and then it, like, kind of goes back, and they do this whole dance number of, like, they're actually together this whole time. Look how happy they are. And then it goes back to, like, ah, no, that didn't actually happen. And maybe it was just because I was sitting there, like, please don't do this. Don't make, like, don't do this ending that... When they started to do the dance number showing them staying together, I was like, oh, cool, let's do this. Come on, stick with it. I started to root for it. And it was taken away from me. I felt angry again. And, well, I understand that ending is kind of meant to be like, either way, they would have been happy. It's just the way life is. There's no bad choices. I like that message. It just felt a little cheap to happen at the end. And the end did kind of come fast, in my opinion, in terms of how the rest of the movie was paced. It just was like, here's all this happening, and then boom, it's done. Which I think Chazelle struggles with. I haven't seen First Man, but I can say for sure Whiplash has an incredibly premature ending. Great movie, but I don't understand that ending and why it was made. But maybe that's another video. Regardless, La La Land, there's a lot of talent behind it. There's a lot of good ideas in La La Land. It just felt like Chazelle lost himself. And I think he may be one of those directors and writers who needs other perspectives and other people to kind of bounce ideas off of and reel him in sometimes. I think he's talented. I haven't yet to see one of his movies that truly speaks to me. And I just really hated how La La Land became, in my opinion, Oscar bait. And it was just disappointing to watch because I was really looking forward to it. If you all enjoyed this video, please be sure to leave it a like, subscribe to our channel, share it with anyone you care to. We are continuing to grow. We're continuing to create a community that's been awesome. Thank you all for being a part of it and for helping us to do so. We do have a new public Discord, so if you want to be a part of that, let us know. Reach out in the comments and we'll send you a link to it. We'd love to have you in there. It's going to be a lot of fun. And for all your unpopular opinions and more, be sure to check back in here with ScoopHash.